गुड मॉर्निंग।
गुड मॉर्निंग मैम।
गुड मॉर्निंग आप।
अभिनव सुचने वीडियो युवा यू रिमेम्बर एनीथिंग फ्रॉम द लास्ट क्लास?
यस मैम।
यस, व्हाट डू यू रिमेम्बर?
We were discussing behaviors last. We discussed about overt and covert behaviors.
Overt and covert behaviors, yes. Then?
Psychology as a discipline.
Psychology as a discipline. Overt and covert behavior and the things that you remember about behavior as such is from your recent memory. We call it recency effect. If a series of things are presented to you, then if you remember the last set of items, then that means it is a recency effect. You are experiencing a recency effect. Suppose if you remember the first thing that was presented in the series, then that is the primacy effect. Just for your general knowledge, nothing related to our portion anyways, but recency effect and primacy effect, it happens in daily life. You remember the definition of psychology? Yes.
Yes,
that is
ma'am.
The first thing that we learned, isn't it? So that is the primacy effect having an influence on you. Anyways, Emily, are you not well? Emily?
Yes ma'am, I'm not well.
Okay, get well soon. All right. Yes, you told me about behavior, overt and covert behavior. What is the overt behavior, Abdul? What is overt behavior? I told you to connect with another word starting with O.
Behavior which we can see
or rather more scientifically than seeing,
observe.
Yes, the behaviors which we can observe, they are known as overt behaviors, and the opposite of overt behaviors are
not observable.
Not observable. What do you call them, Amal Roshan?
Covert
behaviors. Very good. Okay. Now, we also learned that behaviors are of different types. It can be short term or enduring. It can be long term. Then it can be simple as well as complex. Yes. Then, what did we learn about experiences? Please switch on your videos, everyone. Rose, Omar, Bazuri. Come on.
Experiences can be affected by both internal and external factors.
Yes, experiences can be affected by both internal factors as well as external factors. And experiences are dash in nature.
Subjective
in nature. Then, what was the first process? The first key element in our definition?
Mental processes.
Mental processes. What did we learn about mental process? Can you give me some examples of mental processes?
Decision making, thinking.
Learning.
Thinking, learning. Then? Only two.
Knowing.
Problem solving. Decision making. All those comes under our mental processes. Okay, I'm happy that you know at least this much. Now, who will tell me the definition? Definition of psychology. Sanam, would you try?
Psychology is defined formally as a science which studies about mental processes, experiences and behavior in different contexts.
Very good. In different contexts, yes. Then, which origin do we have for the term psychology?
Greek.
Greek origin. And what does the term psyche mean?
Soul.
Soul. Sandra, what does the term logos mean? Study of some particular subject or science. Those meanings are there. Okay. Now, 1879. Why is it a golden year in the field of psychology?
First laboratory in the University of Leipzig.
Mm. Shreya, if you want to speak something, unmute and speak. I'd like to hear from you, okay? And Meryl also. I notice you are telling the answer, but it's not reaching me. I can't look at all your lips and sit, isn't it? Yeah. So, first laboratory in the field of psychology was set up in the year 1879. It was by Willem Wundt, which we'll study in the coming portion. And what else? Where was it set up, Anila?
Germany.
Germany. University of?
Leipzig.
Leipzig. All right. Okay, now we also started with the portion psychology as a discipline, and there we were discussing if psychology is a natural science or a social science or both. And what did we conclude? Psychology both. Is a what
it's
science?
Both.
It is both, and there is a term for it. What is it called?
Hybrid.
Hybrid. It is a hybrid science. Psychology is a hybrid science. And I don't know how many of you agree that psychology is a hybrid science, but according to our syllabus, according to our portion, we have to study that psychology is a hybrid science. When you finish the course, you will have better understanding of the subject. So you are free to decide which path you are taking or what opinions you are having. Okay. After the course, if you think that psychology is only a natural science, you are free to believe that. And if you think that psychology is only a social science, again, you are free to go with that opinion. You can move forward with that opinion. But only thing is, you should have your own arguments to prove that it is so. Okay. Yes, so psychology as a natural science and a social science. That's the topic that we are going to deal with today. Yes, you can write the heading, psychology as a discipline. Under that comes psychology as a natural science and psychology as a social science. Amar Roshan, you had a haircut?
Yeah.
Okay. Fine. Omar, please switch on your video. Okay. So, psychology as a natural science. We'll begin with that. What are the characteristics of a natural science? Consider physics, biology, chemistry and all and tell me. Why would we include psychology in that category?
It is proven by certain experiments and research and certain facts are based on it.
So we have facts there, we have experiments there, then research, we can do research. Then what do we call the collection of these known facts in natural science? we study that known facts in the form of something, right? What is it? Yes, Emeline, are you telling me something? No. Any idea?
Information.
What's the question?
Information. Okay. What's the question? Okay. The question is, yeah, Omar, information I agree, but there is a particular term under which we study all the known facts in natural science. Malavika? It's not audible.
Can you hear?
Ah, yes. What is it?
Theory.
Theory, yes, theory. We have certain theories in physics, chemistry, biology, everything, right? We have laws, theories, theorems. Yes, and that is a proven thing. And for many elements in a particular field of study, in a particular natural science, we have definitions for them too. Like in biology, photosynthesis, we have a definition for it. And because of that, we have a common understanding of that subject, isn't it? Yes, Sanam, remember what photosynthesis is?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, thank God. Then, in physics, tell me any phenomenon in physics.
Friction.
Friction, yes. Condensation, evaporation. We have a common understanding because we have a definition for that particular thing. Isn't it? Then, what else in chemistry?
Combustion.
Combustion. Combustion is physics as well as chemistry. Anyways, then, anything else? Concentration, saturation, all those things. We understand that, we have a common understanding of that because there is a definition. There is an objective explanation for it. Otherwise, if there was no such definition or explanation, we would have defined it in different ways, isn't it? For example, combustion, or for example, photosynthesis, the most simple one. If my understanding is different from what Eva understand about photosynthesis, then what we convey to others will be different. Suppose if we both become teachers, biology teachers, and I teach my students with my understanding of photosynthesis, and she teaches her students with her understanding of photosynthesis, then if our students meet, there will be a big clash, isn't it? Because there are different opinions in both of our understandings also. So we have a common understanding of the subject, we have a theory to explain the particular phenomena, we have certain definitions, we have objectivity in a natural science. Understood? And in psychology, we define psychology, isn't it? Yes. And we also discuss that the psychological attributes like intelligence, it can be measured. Yes. Then experiments can be conducted, research can be conducted in the field of psychology. So that is why we are considering psychology as a natural science. Okay, now we'll do an activity, not an overt activity, but still think of the example. You all are psychologists, you all have become psychologists, imagine so. And one client is coming on a Monday morning, and the client is a child. And the child is showing very much aggressiveness towards whatever is there in the room. The child is kept in a room and you're watching the child, or you're observing the child's behavior from another room. I hope you have seen those in films. The what do you call them?
One-sided glass.
One-sided rooms. With one-sided windows where you can watch them but they cannot see that they are being watched. Okay, so you are observing that particular child, and this child is very much angry. The anger outbursts have reached the peak level, and you are a psychologist, so you have to understand that particular behavior, isn't it? So what is the first thing that comes to the mind, comes to your mind?
What's Meryl. Troubling them?
Something is troubling them.
Yeah.
Yes.
To find the cause of the trouble.
Yes. So you will be trying to find the cause of the trouble.
Yes.
Yes. Meryl. I saw your lips moving. That's why I'm asking.
The child is being hyper
active. The child is being hyperactive. Okay. then think Abhinav.
Why that children is acting like that? Is that
no children,
question?
Only one child is there.
Child is acting, that is the question, ma'am.
No, you are a psychologist and you're watching, you're observing this particular child who is showing increased aggressive behaviors. And the emotions, the expressions and the body language suggest that this child is very much angry. Okay. And you are trying to observe that and you are giving a report to me. So what will be the first thing that comes to your mind? That's the question.
Ma'am, past trauma?
Sorry, past trauma?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Is that a question or you fixed it? Past trauma or past trauma?
Past trauma.
Fixed, okay. Then.
check the child's behavior and characteristics and see if he is, can be put into a certain group. Like, you know how maybe if he has some kind of condition.
A health condition?
Yeah.
Like organic condition?
A mental condition.
Mental condition, okay. Then. I need more inputs.
I mean, he is usually like this, or only now he's like this.
He has been like this, or is it? Is he behaving like that now? Okay. Who told it's a he? Did I tell the gender of the child? Did I mention? No, we assumed. That's because you have a mental set that men or boys show more aggressive behaviors. You have to change that.
Oh, ma'am, I saw some film.
No, it is because of that it automatically came into your words. It's there in your subconscious mind.
Exactly what you said was that boy doing, so that's what came in my mind.
Okay, fine. Then. Come on. That's all.
And the child may not be used to the environment because he may have been subjected to prolonged period of isolation.
Prolonged isolation?
Yeah.
Okay. Then, why is he angry? That is the thing that we are studying now. Through the method of observation. Okay? Imagine this is a kind of research. We are studying why is this guy angry. I am assuming that this is a guy now. Okay? For easier conversation. And guys, no offense. Then, Abhinav.
Ma'am, that guy has stress, immense amount of stress.
Guy has?
Immense amount of stress.
Immense amount of stress. Okay.
He can't handle, so that if any something happened, he will be violent. So much.
Yeah. So a small a small stressor can induce even more stress in that person.
Yes.
That's what you're trying to make. Okay. Then.
Ma'am, he must have taken some kind of illegal substance.
He must have taken some illegal substance, yes, that is a possibility. Then. That's all. Okay. Who told me about the past trauma? Kevin, right?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. How do you know that past traumas can cause a problem, such a problem in a child?
Ma'am, because when someone, it's like we learn from our experiences. Say we touched fire once, we'll remember not to do it again. And it just keeps on coming again and again in his mind.
So where did you learn that first?
Not sure, ma'am.
Where did we learn, or in which subject, under which subject did you learn that touching fire that causes a reflex action?
Biology.
Science. You didn't have biology, physics and chemistry earlier, right? You started with science. EVS. After EVS, we came to science. And now we are again splitting and studying. Yes. So in science or in EVS, you have learned about a particular theoretical concept that this is the mechanism. Yes. And that we are applying to our daily life. Okay, so we have a theory there. Now, we'll just take the example for past trauma, and we'll evaluate how the case is. Generally, when we do a research, we form hypothesis. Do you know what a hypothesis is?
Yes.
Prediction.
Assumptions.
Prediction, assumption, they are tentative statements. Tentative means they may change. They might change after the research. Okay, so suppose we are assuming that this particular child is having a past trauma. And that is our hypothesis. Past trauma can cause aggressive behaviors, or past trauma induces aggression. That is our hypothesis. We don't know if this is true. We have to do the research. We have to check and find out. Okay. So, we collect data. What is the theory here? It is a theoretical concept from the scientific subjects that we have learned. So, we have a theoretical background for it. Based on the theory only, we have developed the hypothesis, isn't it? You agree?
Yes, ma'am.
If we didn't know the theory, we will not develop the hypothesis based on past trauma. We'll go for some other topic which we already know, which is theoretically true, which is a fact, which is a known fact. So again, based on the theoretical concept, we have developed a hypothesis, which is a tentative statement, which is like an assumption. Now we'll do the research, we'll collect data, we'll search for the past history of this child, we'll talk with the bystanders, we'll talk with the family members, we'll talk with the teachers at school, we'll talk with the close friends, the peer group, and understand, is this behavior happening all the time, at what circumstances does this behavior come out, then has he been showing this behavior from his childhood. I mean, he's still a child, but from the early ages till this age, is he showing this behavior? Then based on that, we might also predict what will happen in the future or the coming days. Based on that, we conclude our hypothesis. So, we understand that he had a past trauma. He had some problems in his early childhood. We'll find out what the trauma was. And then finally, we'll, we'll accept the hypothesis that the past trauma is causing an aggressive behavior in this child. We'll accept the hypothesis. Suppose we find out from our study that this particular child did not have any past trauma, then we reject the hypothesis at the end of the research. And so we can do another research to find out what the real cause was. So again, we'll take another hypothesis. Suppose this child is having a health condition that is causing the abnormal or the aggressive behaviors, like some hormonal changes or neurotransmitter problems or any preterm birth, any problem like that might have caused, any organic cause might have caused these aggressive behaviors. We'll assume that, we'll put that into the hypothesis and we'll do the study again. So even that hypothesis based on our previous understanding of this theoretical concept, we have not us, but at least I have learned that certain hormones and certain neurotransmitters. If there is an imbalance in these particular chemical substances, it can cause aggressive behaviors. If I know that theory, then I can make this hypothesis, I can do the study again. Understood? So, why did I explain all these things? Because in science, in when we consider psychology as a natural science, we have a method or we have a model called hypothetico-deductive model. Hypothetico-deductive model or hypothetico-deductive method. Which means we'll form a hypothesis, we'll deduce from it, and we'll understand the concept. Hypothetical, deductive. From the hypothesis, we will deduce the concepts. Okay,
so
and yes.
Is it like a trial and error kind of method?
Yes, it can be considered as a trial and error method. But
like you form something and then you try to relate it with it, but it doesn't work, so you try something else.
Yeah, every study is a trial and error method, isn't it? Even if we do an experiment, it is a trial and error method. It can be considered, but scientifically we call it hypothetico-deductive method. We form a hypothesis, and based on what did we form the hypothesis? Based on a theory, based on a known fact. Based on the theory, we form a hypothesis, then we deduce that, and then we learn the concept. Did you get at least a vague idea of what this is?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am. We'll go on, we'll read the PPT and then you'll understand more. Okay, psychology as a natural science. Modern psychology has developed because of the application of the scientific method to study psychological phenomena that we already discussed. Scientific method means it has the objectivity, it has this hypothesis, it has this theory and all the things. The experiments that we do, the research that we do, everything comes under the scientific method. Okay. As a physical science, it emphasizes on data that is systematic and can be studied under controlled conditions. Controlled conditions. What do we do under controlled conditions? We do experiments. We do research, isn't it? We try to control certain factors like temperature, noise. If we are doing a psychological study or a psychological test, then it is very important that it is a noise-free environment. We do it in a noise-free environment because suppose we are doing some memory test. The noise from the environment might influence our thought process and again our memory. So it is important that we do it in a noise-free environment. Again, that is a control condition, right? Okay. Then, it can be quantitative and requires analysis. We get a quantity. For example, again, IQ. IQ, that number, is a quantity, right? It suggests how much is your intelligence quotient. We are giving a quantity to our intelligence. Yes, that is quantitative. And note one thing, we have quantitative as well as qualitative analysis in psychology. We learn that in the next chapter, methods of inquiry. There is a lot to discuss about it, so I'm not going deep into that. Then next point, psychology was influenced by René Descartes and it's pronounced as Descartes, not Descartes. And later on by the developments in physics, and it believes in the hypothetico-deductive model. You may please note that hypothetico-deductive model, HDM. So since psychology is considered as a natural science, since it follows the scientific method, it believes in the concept of hypothetico-deductive model or HDM. So if a 1 mark question comes, what is HDM? You have to write hypothetico-deductive model. Finished writing? Shall I change the slide?
Ma'am, 1 second.
Okay. And I told you it follows a scientific method for studying. If it was not a scientific method, then no, we don't have a need to do the research as such. We would have assumed that this boy is like this, this boy has this problem. You might, some people might have assumed this boy has a past trauma. Some people might have assumed he is like this always. Some people might have assumed that it is because of the environmental problems. Some people might have assumed that it is because of the biological issues like hormones or neurotransmitters. Okay, that is a common sense method. It's not a scientific method because we don't have a proof. We have not done the study properly. We have not set the hypothesis based on a theoretical concept. We just assumed. Just like the common man or the layperson does. Okay. When it comes to scientific method, we have to do that in these steps. We have to set the hypothesis based on a theory. Then we have to do the whole process of research to confirm that this is because of this. Got it? Okay, I'm changing the slide. The model suggests that scientific advancement can take place if you have a theory to explain a phenomenon. Theory is a set of statements about, you can write down that point. Theory is a set of statements about how a certain complex phenomenon, I'll repeat once more. Theory is a set of statements about how a certain complex phenomenon can be explained with the help of prepositions which are interrelated. Which are interrelated. Then the definition of hypothesis also. A hypothesis is a tentative solution. Tentative means which can change, which might change. It's not permanent. Okay. A hypothesis is a tentative solution to a problem. A hypothesis is a tentative solution to a problem that helps in guiding a research or a theory. That helps in guiding a research or a theory. Okay. Now, hypothesis has been successfully used for determining many theories related to learning and memory. For example, the way a child has been brought up in his family will shape his personality. If that is a hypothesis, that is a way a child has been brought up in his family will shape his personality. How will we check that this is true or not? We'll take many cases. We'll study that based on the ways they were brought up in the family, and we'll then categorize our conclusions into several things. We'll find out which are the personalities that people are having or these children are having. Okay, that's how we find out things or do a research in psychology. The next one. See, this is the basis of the studies that we do. That is, we develop questions. Is the child behaving in an aggressive manner because of this? That's what we did initially. We discussed all the dimensions of this problem, isn't it? At least some of the dimensions of the problem. Is it past trauma? Is it the biological changes? Is this because of any mental health condition? Is it because of some other problems? Is it because of the environmental factors? We developed certain questions, and based on that, we took we formed a hypothesis. In our case, we took it as past trauma. The past trauma is causing aggressiveness or aggression in this child. That is what we assumed. That is how we selected the hypothesis. We formed the hypothesis. Then we tested the hypothesis. We did the study. We did the research. Through observation method, through interview methods, we talked with this particular child's relatives, with the parents, with the teachers, with the peer group, and then finally we formulated a theory that past trauma, we or else if a theory already exists, we are confirming the theory. If this theory was not present already, then we assume things. We take so many cases together, not only this child's case, we'll take so many cases like this together, then find out if past trauma is causing aggressiveness in a child. I'm talking about, did you understand or are you confused? If this theory that past trauma causes aggressiveness in a child does not exist, imagine this doesn't exist at all, then we'll take so many cases, we call it samples in a study. We take so many samples and then we do a study, formulate the hypothesis and do all the steps. Finally, we form a theory. Okay, now after our generation, after so many years, we have developed a theory on this. So, the psychology students in the future, they can use this theory and form other hypotheses. Did you understand? Now we have a theory at hand, so we confirm the theory. We are not making any new theory. That's a step there. I'll just show you the slide once more. We develop the questions, we form hypothesis, we test the hypothesis, then we formulate the theory if a theory does not exist. If the theory already exists, we confirm the theory. That's it. Here we formulate or we confirm the theory. Okay. These are the basic steps that we engage in. And when we study the second chapter, you'll understand what happens in all these steps. Because we are studying about the methods of inquiry in psychology there. Okay. And the next one, psychology as a social science. We'll discuss and then come to the slide. You might know how psychology is a social science. Tell me. Why would we consider psychology as a social science? We already had a small discussion on it, but still.
Ma'am, because it deals with society and people in general.
Deals with?
Society.
Society and people in general, okay. What all things in the society can influence your behavior? Can the rules that exist in the society influence your behavior?
Yes, the rules and the culture of the people.
Culture, that is very important, cultural factors. In each and every chapter that we study in this course, you will learn about the cultural influences. If you are learning about learning, then you learn about the cultural factors. If you are learning about perception, you learn about the cultural factors. Even the concept of death, that is influenced by cultures. In some cultures, death is caused by demons or evil power. In some cultures, it is a blessing to die. And you'll see how weird the different concepts and different cultures have conceptualized death. Okay, then. Can you give me an example of how the social rules and regulations can influence your behavior?
And if they are so dominant in the society, then it will be automatically practiced without a second thought, even if it's wrong.
Okay, yes, very relevant. Then, I'll give you a simple example. The way you behave at home, is it the same as you behave at school?
No.
No. And the way you behave when you're alone at home, is that the same as you behave when you're with your parents or your siblings?
No.
Never. isn't it? Yes. And the way you sing in your bathroom, is it the same as you sing when you go for a music competition? No. Is it, Amal?
No.
No. Yeah. They are the simple examples of how the social norms and the social expectations of people, the presence of other people as such, is affecting or influencing our behavior and our thought processes. Even if we are acting different, then that means we are thinking different also, isn't it? Yes, our experiences are also different in both the cases. So that's it, psychology as a social science. That's why we are considering psychology as a social science. Psychology is a social science because it studies the behavior of human beings in their social and cultural contexts. Psychology as a social science discipline focuses on humans as social beings. We all are social beings, isn't it? Yes. It focuses on the individual and communities in relation to their social, cultural, and physical environment. The three parts, social, cultural, and also the physical environment, that is your physical surroundings. Anything in your surroundings that forms in the, or that comes under the physical surroundings or physical environment. I think that's it. Did you understand psychology as a natural science and social science?
Can you show the previous slide?
Ma'am, for me too.
Wait. This one?
Yes, ma'am.
Meanwhile, I'll take the attendance. Science batch students, just listen. Noorin was there in psychology class first day, right? On day one, Noorin. Is she still in psychology or did she attend the class by mistake? You don't know? No idea. Okay. Abhiram is absent today.
Ma'am, present.
Where are you? Where is Abhiram? Ah, oh, okay. Abhijit.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, present. Abhilash.
Present.
Amal. Amal Roshan. Present. Basuri.
Present.
Kevin.
Present, ma'am.
Omar.
Present, ma'am.
Present. Sanam. Sanam is present, also ma'am. Present, right? Yeah. Sandra.
Present, ma'am.
Present. Sanjana. Sanjana is absent. Okay, then Abdul. Abhinav.
Present, ma'am.
Alina Jason. Absent. Alina Varghese.
Present.
Anila.
Present, ma'am.
Anjana is also there. She's also missing. Okay, then Devika.
Present, ma'am.
Emeline.
Ma'am.
Eva.
Present, ma'am.
Malavika.
Present, ma'am.
Meryl.
Present, ma'am.
Rose and Shreya. Anybody whom I missed? No, right? Okay. So you can study this portion and come for the next class, right? Only a few points to remember. Yes, I'll send you one case study for those who don't have the book, and for those who have it, it's there in page number 5. There is a short story, but in psychology we call it case study. It's about Ranjida and Shabnam. Please read that up and come for the next class. It's the same topic, how psychology is considered as a social science. A valid case study to prove that it is a social science. Okay. Abdul, any changes in your opinion? Not yet. Yes.
Social.
Okay. Anyways, read it and come for the next class. Okay. For those who don't have the book, I'll put in the class group. I'll take a picture and put in the class group. Okay. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am.